In mathematics, deformation theory is the study of infinitesimal conditions associated with varying a solution p of a problem to slightly different solutions p epsilon, where epsilon is a small number, or vector of small quantities. The infinitesimal conditions are therefore the result of applying the approach of differential calculus to solving a problem with constraints. One might think, in analogy, of a structure that is not completely rigid, and that deforms slightly to accommodate forces applied from the outside. This explains the name. Some characteristic phenomena are, the derivation of first-order equations by treating the epsilon quantities as having negligible squares, the possibility of isolated solutions, in that varying a solution may not be possible, or does not bring anything new, and the question of whether the infinitesimal constraints actually integrate, so that their solution does provide small variations. In some form these considerations have a history of centuries in mathematics, but also in physics and engineering. For example, in the geometry of numbers a class of results called isolation theorems was recognized, with the topological interpretation of an open orbit of a group action around a given solution. Perturbation theory also looks at deformations, in general of operators. Topic: Deformations of complex manifolds. The most salient deformation theory in mathematics has been that of complex manifolds and algebraic varieties. This was put on a firm basis by foundational work of Kunihiko Kodira and Donald C. Spencer, after deformation techniques had received a great deal of more tentative application in the Italian school of algebraic geometry. One expects, intuitively, that deformation theory of the first order should equate the Zariski tangent space with a moduli space. The phenomena turn out to be rather subtle, though, in the general case. In the case of Riemann surfaces, one can explain that the complex structure on the Riemann sphere is isolated, no moduli. For genus 1, an elliptic curve has a one-parameter family of complex structures, as shown in elliptic function theory. The general Kodira-Spencer theory identifies as the key to the deformation theory the sheaf cohomology group H 1 theta display style H underscore 1 theta, where theta is the sheaf of germs of sections of the holomorphic tangent bundle. There is an obstruction in the H2 of the same sheaf, which is always zero in case of a curve, for general reasons of dimension. In the case of genus 0 the H1 vanishes, also. For genus 1 the dimension is the Hodge number H1, 0 which is therefore 1. It is known that all curves of genus 1 have equations of form Y2. Topic: X3 plus X plus B. These obviously depend on two parameters, A and B, whereas the isomorphism classes of such curves have only one parameter. Hence there must be an equation relating those A and B which describe isomorphic elliptic curves. It turns out that curves for which B2A-3 has the same value, describe isomorphic curves. I.e. varying A and B is one way to deform the structure of the curve Y2. X3 plus X plus B, but not all variations of A, B actually change the isomorphism class of the curve. One can go further with the case of genus G greater than 1, using Serre duality to relate the H1 to H 0 omega 2 displaystyle H caret 0 omega caret 2, where omega is the holomorphic cotangent bundle and the notation omega 2 means the tensor square, not the second exterior power. In other words, deformations are regulated by holomorphic quadratic differentials on a Riemann surface, again something known classically. The dimension of the moduli space, called Teichmuller space in this case, is computed as 3g-3, by the Riemann-Roch theorem. These examples are the beginning of a theory applying to holomorphic families of complex manifolds, of any dimension. Further developments included, the extension by Spencer of the techniques to other structures of differential geometry, the assimilation of the Kodira-Spencer theory into the abstract algebraic geometry of Grothendieck, with a consequent substantive clarification of earlier work, and deformation theory of other structures, such as algebras. Topic: Functorial description. Another method for formalizing deformation theory is using functors on the category of local Artin algebras over a field. A pre-deformation functor is defined as a functor F Art K sets display style F text Art underscore K to text sets such that F k display style f k is a point. The intuition is that we want to study the infinitesimal structure of some moduli space around a point where lying above that point is the space of interest. It is typically the case that it is easier to describe the functor for a moduli problem instead of finding an actual space. For example, if we want to consider the moduli space of hypersurfaces of degree d display style d in p n display style mathbound p caret n, then we could consider the functor f school sets display style f text school to text sets where f s equals x s. Each fiber is a degree d hypersurface in p n. Display style fluorine monosulfide equals left begin matrix x down arrow s end matrix text. Each fiber is a degree d text hypersurface in mathbound p caret n right. Although in general it is more convenient required to work with functor of groupoids instead of sets. This is true for moduli of curves. Topic: Technical remarks about infinitesimals. Infinitesimals have long been in use by mathematicians for non-rigorous arguments in calculus. The idea is that if we consider polynomials f x epsilon display style f x var epsilon with an infinitesimal epsilon display style var epsilon, then only the first order terms really matter. That is, we can consider f x epsilon f x plus epsilon g x plus o epsilon 2 display style f x var epsilon equivalent f x plus var epsilon g x plus o var epsilon caret 2. A simple application of this is that we can find the derivatives of monomials using infinitesimals x plus epsilon 3 equals x 3 plus 3 x 2 epsilon plus o epsilon 2 display style x plus var epsilon caret 3 equals x caret 3 plus 3 x caret 2 var epsilon plus o var epsilon caret 2. The epsilon display style var epsilon term contains the derivative of the monomial, demonstrating its use in calculus. We could also interpret this equation as the first two terms of the Taylor expansion of the monomial. Infinitesimals can be made rigorous using nilpotent elements in local Artin algebras. In the ring K y 2 display style K y caret 2, we see that arguments with infinitesimals can work. This motivates the notation k epsilon equals k y 2 display style k var epsilon equals k y caret 2. Moreover, if we want to consider higher order terms of a Taylor approximation, then we could consider the Artin algebras k y k display style k y caret k. For our monomial, suppose we want to write out the second order expansion, then x plus epsilon 3 equals x 3 plus 3 x 2 epsilon plus 3 x epsilon 2 plus epsilon 3 display style x plus var epsilon caret 3 equals x caret 3 plus 3 x caret 2 var epsilon plus 3 x var epsilon caret 2 plus var epsilon caret 3. Recall that a Taylor expansion at 0 can be written out as f x equals f 0 plus F 1 X 1 plus F 2 X 2 plus F 3 X 3 plus display style F x equals F 0 plus frac F caret 1 X 1 plus frac F caret 2 X 2 plus frac F caret 3 X 3 plus C D O T S. Hence the previous two equations show that the second derivative of X 3 display style X caret 3 is 6 X display style 6 X. In general, since we want to consider arbitrary order Taylor expansions in any number of variables, we will consider the category of all local Artin algebras over a field. Topic: Motivation. To motivate the definition of a pre-deformation functor, consider the projective hypersurface over a field. Project C x 0 x 1 x 2 x 3 x 0 4 plus x 1 4 plus x 2 4 plus x 3 4 spec K display style begin matrix operator name project left DFRAC mathbound C x underscore 0 x underscore 1 x underscore 2 x underscore 3 x underscore 0 carrot 4 plus x underscore 1 carrot 4 plus x underscore 2 carrot 4 plus x underscore 3 carrot 4 right down arrow operator name spec K end matrix. If we want to consider an infinitesimal deformation of this space, then we could write down a Cartesian square. Project C x 0 x 1 x 2 x 3 x 0 4 plus x 1 4 plus x 2 4 plus x 3 4 project C x 0 x 1 x 2 x 3 epsilon x 0 4 plus x 1 4 plus x 2 4 plus x 3 4 plus epsilon x 0 0 x 1 1 x 2 a 2 by 3 a 3 spec k epsilon display style begin matrix operator name project left DFRAC mathbound C x underscore 0 x underscore 1 x underscore 2 x underscore 3 x underscore 0 carrot 4 plus x underscore 1 carrot 4 plus x underscore 2 carrot 4 plus x underscore 3 carrot 4 right and to an operator name project left DFRAC mathbound C x underscore 0 x underscore 1 x underscore 2 x underscore 3 var epsilon x underscore 0 carrot 4 plus x underscore 1 carrot 4 plus x underscore 2 carrot 4 plus x underscore 3 carrot 4 plus var epsilon x underscore 0 carrot a underscore 0 x underscore 1 carrot a underscore 1 x underscore 2 carrot a underscore 2 x underscore 3 carrot a underscore 3 right down arrow and down arrow operator name spec k and to an operator name spec k var epsilon end matrix where a 0 plus a 1 plus a 2 plus a 3 equals 4 display style r underscore 0 plus a underscore 1 plus a underscore 2 plus a underscore 3 equals 4. then, the space on the right-hand corner is one example of an infinitesimal deformation, the extra scheme theoretic structure of the nilpotent elements in spec k epsilon display style operator name spec k var epsilon, which is topologically a point, allows us to organize this infinitesimal data. Since we want to consider all possible expansions, we will let our pre-deformation functor be defined on objects as f a equals project c x 0 x 1 x 2 x 3 x 0 4 plus x 1 4 plus x 2 4 plus x 3 4 x spec k spec a display style f a equals left begin matrix operator name project left dfrac mathbound c x underscore 0 x underscore 1 x underscore 2 x underscore 3 x underscore 0 caret 4 plus x underscore 1 caret 4 plus x underscore 2 caret 4 plus x underscore 3 caret 4 right and to an math frac x down arrow and down arrow operator name spec k and to an operator name spec a end matrix right where a display style a is a local R and k display style k algebra. Topic: smooth pre-deformation functors. A pre-deformation functor is called smooth if for any surjection a display style a to a such that the square of any element in the kernel is zero, there is a surjection f a display style f a to f a. This is motivated by the following question: given a deformation x spec k spec a display style begin matrix x and to an math frac x down arrow and down arrow operator name spec k and to an operator name spec a end matrix, does there exist an extension of this Cartesian diagram to the Cartesian diagrams XXX spec k spec a display style begin matrix x and to an math frac x and to an math frac x down arrow and down arrow and down arrow operator name spec k and to an operator name spec a and to an operator name spec a end matrix. The name smooth comes from the lifting criterion of a smooth morphism of schemes. Topic: tangent space. Recall that the tangent space of a scheme X display style X can be described as the HOM display style operator name HOM set T X equals HOM school K spec K X X display style tx equals operator name hom underscore text school k operator name spec k x x. Since we are considering the tangent space of a point of some moduli space, we can define the tangent space of our pre-deformation functor as t f equals f k epsilon display style t underscore f equals f k var epsilon. Topic: applications of deformation theory. Topic: bend and break. Deformation theory was famously applied in birational geometry by Shigefumi Mori to study the existence of rational curves on varieties. For a Fano variety of positive dimension, Mori showed that there is a rational curve passing through every point. The method of the proof later became known as Mori's bend and break. The rough idea is to start with some curve C through a chosen point and keep deforming it until it breaks into several components. Replacing C by one of the components has the effect of decreasing either the genus or the degree of C, so after several repetitions of the procedure, eventually we'll obtain a curve of genus 0, i.e. a rational curve. The existence and the properties of deformations of C require arguments from deformation theory and a reduction to positive characteristic. Topic: arithmetic deformations. One of the major applications of deformation theory is in arithmetic. It can be used to answer the following question: if we have a variety x f p display style x mathbound f underscore p What are the possible extensions?
X Z P
display style math frac x math bound z underscore p. If our variety is a curve, then the vanishing
h 2
display style h caret 2 implies that every deformation induces a variety over
z p
display style math bound z underscore p. That is, if we have a smooth curve
x spec f p
display style begin matrix x down arrow operator name spec math bound f underscore p end matrix x and a deformation xx2 spec fp spec z p2 display style begin matrix x and to an math frac x underscore 2 down arrow and an down arrow operator name spec math bound f underscore p and to an operator name spec math bound z p caret 2 end matrix, then we can always extend it to a diagram of the form xx2 x 3 spec fp spec z p2 spec z p3 display style begin matrix x and to an math frac x underscore 2 and to an math frac x underscore 3 and to cdots down arrow and down arrow and down arrow and operator name spec math bound f underscore p and to an operator name spec math bound z p caret 2 and to an operator name spec math bound z p caret 3 and to cdots end matrix. This implies that we can construct a formal scheme x equals spec x display style math frac x equals operator name spec math frac x underscore bullet giving a curve over
z
p display style math bound z underscore p. Topic: deformations of abelian schemes. The serratate theorem asserts, roughly speaking, that the deformations of abelian scheme A is controlled by deformations of the p-divisible group
A
p
infinity
display style A p caret inf t consisting of its p-power torsion points. Topic: Galois deformations. Another application of deformation theory is with Galois deformations. It allows us to answer the question, if we have a Galois representation
G
GL
N
F P display style G to operator name GL underscore N math bound F underscore P, how can we extend it to a representation
G GL N Z P
display style G to operator name GL underscore N math bound Z underscore P text. Topic: relationship to string theory. The so-called DeLine conjecture arising in the context of algebras and Hochschild cohomology stimulated much interest in deformation theory in relation to string theory, roughly speaking, to formalize the idea that a string theory can be regarded as a deformation of a point particle theory. This is now accepted as proved, after some hitches with early announcements. Maxim Koncevich is among those who have offered a generally accepted proof of this. Topic: see also Exolcom, cotangent complex, Gromov-Witten invariant, moduli of algebraic curves.